Hi everyone, Izzy Noodles here with part 3 of Jungle Ruins as voted for by you. Sort of. I gave you a strict option of the same game, so in a way it wasn't much of your choice. Anyway, welcome back. So we start off in this small area, just behind those rocks over there. We've got a section we can get to, not from here though, we'll have to work our way round to there. And just by this tree we have some healing herbs, so don't forget that is a small med pack. Just around this corner there is a gate which we will need a key for, and the assumption would be that's the end of level gate, just like in the previous two levels, but that's actually not the case at all this time round. Also there is another healing herb right here. And right now this seems like a little bit of a dead end, but if we come back to where we entered the level, there is this up here, so just hop on up, pull the lever, and that opens the gate right here. This is not timed, but the door will close behind you. I'm gonna equip my shotgun because there will be a native in here. Come on. Point blank range. There we go. So in this area there is a door which we will need a gem to open, and also you may have already spotted there is a key right up there. So to get that, just hop back onto this slope and hop forward again. There we go, and this key goes into that door we were just near. Also gonna equip my pistols again, make sure they're equipped, because once we drop down there will be a kitty. Okay, so now we're back at the starting point of the level. So come to the door, the gate, or the door, whichever. Could be either. Use our gold key we picked up. And then follow it around, but you want to be careful at the end because there is a pit. Like so. So I am going to save it just because I do mess up a fair bit right here for like no reason. I'm just overly cautious and overly clumsy. So do a standing jump to this ledge. Oh, you see, you never know. And then we can do a running jump down to there. You see there's a lever, so just make your way down. Cool beans. And before I pull that, I'm just going to hop up here to get some flares. Okay, so this lever, if you just have a look up there, you can see a green bit in the ceiling in the corner. That's actually an opening. So this lever raises a block, and it is timed. And also, I'm not sure whether it's the lever that raises that grate on the wall, that platform, or whether it's just a trigger tile as we run up to it, but either way, none of these things stay there for long, so you do want to be quick. And I know I've just saved, but I always like to save before a timer. It's just me, it's not necessary, I just like saving at timers. Okie dokie, so it is pretty simple. And as you run across the platform, you are better doing that, just hopping across the corners much faster. There we go. So to the right is a dead end, and just up here to the left we've got some steps going up there. We need to raise a block in that section. Lever to do so is through this gate here. Obviously we need to find a way to open the gate. Just grab these flares, and if we come down here now, come over here, if we have a look, you see that flame on the wall there? That's actually the starting point where we started in the level. So this is that section behind the rocks. So the lever we want to open that gate is just over here. So after you've pulled that, hop on down. And in this section, we have a door that needs to be opened with a gem. And also, we are actually now stuck in this little section. But to get out, you just want to pull this cage across onto the odd tile. And I don't believe you can actually stand on these. No, you can't. Okay, so that's raised this block, so we can now climb on up. Head through the gate we've just opened, and we need to pull two levers to raise a block in that other area. Oh, that's a good view. So first one is straight across to the right. So it's shown as the block, but nothing has happened. And you do want to be careful, because if you fall down, you have to go all the way past that pit again, all the way through there. So just be very careful. So next one is just round here, up on this block. Cool beans. So now, heading straight to that section. Where is that section? There it is. Here is the block. So as we come around the corner, we will trigger a crow, and you are better off fighting it on the ground. And it's quite easy to avoid. You can stand on the spot and just keep rolling. Though the last time I played it, it lingered near me quite a lot. So it took a little bit of damage. There we go, that was easier. Didn't give me any jip that time. So climb back up. And just at this raised bit, you can jump up and grab this. Over to here. And you can see where we're aiming for now. So you want to use the slope, jump to the ledge, and jump to the next area. But below the ledge, on the pedestal there, there is a secret. That's a shotgun. So firstly, I will be going for that. I'll save here because I have overshot this slope before, because I'm obviously not very good at playing. Okay, so you kind of want to fake grab. You want to go to grab, but then immediately let go, and she will land on the ledge and just take the tiniest bit of damage. There we go. There is our secret of the level. So obviously, you do want to just climb back up. Come on. There we go. So this time when you jump to the ledge, you actually want to jump a bit further down, a bit lower down on the slope, so that she's more likely to grab the higher ledge, because sometimes she can miss. Risking not saving again. Yes, I thought I was gonna miss. And then just run and jump to here. And as you can see, there are various spike traps here. So on this column, on the left of it, there is a timed lever that will open that door. And behind that door, there is a timed lever that will open that door. Now the first lever is pretty simple. Easy enough. Whoa, she says as she nearly runs off the edge. See, I didn't even just sprint there, really. Oh no, why did I pull it? I wanted to save, because it's a lot more tedious. Let's just wait. So if you do struggle with this one, you can just run, take the shorter way, but you will run through spikes and take a little bit of damage. It's easy enough not to. Okay, wish me luck. So it's a case of sprinting and then taking your finger off. So in here, obviously, two natives have turned up already. I'm gonna use my revolver. So when you've shot those two, this firestone will appear on this pedestal, and the door will then open. And now we can go and use it. We just have to make our way there. Whoops. Well, that's all right. So we're not far away anyway. Just the section behind the rocks. Over here. And we do get some crazy music. But there's no need to be alarmed. There is nothing that's gonna come and get you. So come to the left. Follow it to the land. So in this section, we have a door to the right. That is a return path, so ignore that for now. There is a door to the left. You can just see there is a skeletal torso there without a head, so we will need to find the skull to open that door. And the only place we can go is straight ahead, so just grab this healing herb and head on down. So there is a pit, and you do want to grab the edge. So there is a watery section to the left, just ignore that for now and come to the right. So in here, there is a jump switch up there. Pull that, and that raises this block, so you can pull that lever there, and that will raise a block somewhere else. So let's go and get that jump switch. There we go. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. There we go, that should work. Yosh. I'm gonna save because sometimes she actually misses for no reason. Okay, so just run and jump. Okie dokie. Pull this. And we can see that's raised a block somewhere else. So that's actually across the water section. So let's go across there, see what we can find. Oh, I wanted it to sprint through the water. That didn't work. So just climb up here. And you want to be just at this slightly higher point. And you need to do a standing jump. She won't grab if you do a running jump. It's like the distance isn't quite right for that. It's a bit strange. But this block straight ahead is the one we've just raised. And the lever here is timed. And you see the crack in the ledge just there, the crack in the wall? This lever will raise a block so we can grab that ledge. So let's go quickly, quickly, quickly. So it barely gives you enough time, this one. So the moment she went to jump is when the block went down. So shimmy along until you can pull up. and then hop up to the monkey bars. Follow this along. You can see we'll go onto a wall ladder in a moment. Okay, so to grab the wall ladder, just quickly let go and grab again. And now we can see what we came for. So now, obviously, you may have already known we were coming to get the skull. So now we can exit to use that. But we need to find the exit. So I say we need to find the exit because the way we came down, that drop is too high to actually be able to jump back up and reach. So we need to find a different way out. So come back over here where we were first pulling all the levers. And there is a trap door in the ceiling. We need to raise this column a little bit more so we can reach the trap door. And there is a lever hidden in plain sight right here. So that's what's gonna make this column just a little bit higher. So we can't actually reach it from here, but there is a gap in the wall just up here. Now it's important you do a run and jump and grab in the air for this, because otherwise she won't be able to grab the edge of this. Super duper. So the gate will open. And now we'll come around. And we can use the skull. So let me just point out, by the entrance there is a passage to the right, just so you know that's there. I'm going to bypass it for now. Come down here to the left, and there will be a native, so ready your shotgun. And he will be on the left hand side. Come on. Why won't these people die? There we go. He drops a silver key. Also, while I'm in here, I will point out that receptacle right there. So that's a sign that we will need to come back to this place. And also right now, we need two jungle skulls. So first one is up here. And just be careful when you get to the top. There is a lot of fire and spikes going on. Okay, so hop to here. And then here, just mind all the traps. Here is the first jungle skull that we will be needing. So it's just a little tricky to get back down. There we go, nailed it. I don't usually. Okie dokie. So now we're going to go and get the second one. So come up to this passage. And there are two ways to go here. There's a way through the water, we don't need to go that way yet. And there's this pit here. So inside, drop down, and there are some shotgun shells. And here, we can use the silver key we've just picked up from that native. So that opens the trap door. And this lever will open this hatch, but I will first make sure I've got my revolver equipped. There are a couple of natives down here, and it's not so easy to jump about. Okay, because the ceilings can be low, so it can be difficult to jump around. So somewhere in here, not this end, this is the trapdoor that we're going to open. The other end is the jump switch that will open the trapdoor. Okie dokie. Somewhere, there it is, somewhere in the room is the second jungle skull. Once you pick that up, the door will open. And we've got our return path through the water just there. But firstly, there is... where is it? There it is. A healing herb. Now, hop on in. Just under here. And you can see the bubbles. That is an indicator of where the air hole is, where we need to be going. Where am I? There I am. So, when we come down here, we are back in a familiar spot. That is where we shot the native and got the silver key. So, come back up and we're going to come through this passage again. This time we're going to go through the water. And in this area, we do not get air bubbles showing us where the air hole is. So you have to find it. It's easy enough to find, I think. Yeah, there it is. See what I tell you. So, climb out. Couple more natives, so I'm gonna ready my shotgun. One of them comes from around the corner, one of them comes from inside the building. She seems good at missing them. There we go. So just around the side there is a healing plant, so large med pack. And now head inside and we will see why we needed jungle skulls. So place them and the blocks will raise here, allowing us to pull that cage all the way along. Okie dokie. So grab the cage and take it all the way to the other side. Alrighty, so once that is in place, you can hear that this door opens and we have another firestone. So this is to be put in the receptacle where we shot the native and got the silver key. So I do recommend saving right here, just because I once had a bug where I couldn't then get out of the water. It's only happened once, but it still happened nevertheless. So I feel certain that I will be able to get out. It's just, it happened once and it's the kind of thing that would make you cautious, because once is enough times. There we go. Here we are, use the firestone. And this block will lower. I bet you thought it would raise, didn't you? So crawl on in. We've got a bit of a long passage now. And I don't think you can flip out. No, you can't flip out of this gap because the ceiling's too low. Oh, wrong button. Make your way all the way along. There is no boulder trap here. I know it looks like there's a long enough slope for there to be a boulder trap, but there's not. Don't panic. And you'll need to press the crouch button to climb into that gap. And you don't want to flip out here. I don't know if she can, but there is a bit of a drop. Okie dokie. So in this area is what I sometimes call the Tiger Stone, because it looks amazing. Look at that. That's the best gem ever. So it's actually called a Jungle Stone, and it's showing us exactly where to use it. And it's also showing us there that after you pick it up, column will raise so that we can get out. And you may not know where we are. We're in the pit where we had that timer with the grate and the block. You know, the green patch in the ceiling. That bit. Long ladder of ladder. Hokey pokey. So from here, you can just do a standing jump. And then jump to here. Come out of this section, try not to find any walls. And we're gonna go through the doorway again over here. So you need to hop up and pull the lever. So don't forget, it is not timed, but it will close behind you. And this time, we have a tiger. So I'm going to choose my pistols. Whoa. Okay, that got a bit crazy. So here we go. So just grab the ledge to drop down here, and I'm going to point out a few things. We've got a random monkey bar up there, and this block in front of Lara can be raised so that you can reach that opening up there if we come round the corner. That doorway is a return path, so just ignore that. In the corner, it doesn't look like it, but a block can raise from there, so we can reach a lever. That lever will open the block on the other side, raise the block on the other side. And it looks like that's pretty much it in this area, so what do we do? So if we actually come to the edge, just try not to fall, we don't want to fall, and look down. There is an opening right there. That is so easy to get to. So all you need to do is drop and hang. And the same again, drop and hang. And now, climb up and flip and turn and grab. Easy peasy. So in here, a native will come around the corner. So I'm going to choose my revolver because there are some spike traps in here, and I don't want to be jumping around while there are spike traps. Also, where is it? There it is. There is a healing plant. And the aim here is we have torches here, and we need to ignite this pedestal so that we can light the torch. So I'm going to drop it just by this pedestal. So equip your weapons to drop a torch down instead of throw it. Just lob it where it lands. So once the torch is lit, we're going to light that little brazier right there. And that will raise the block by that lever. Yeah, words aren't happening too well right now. So I put the torch near the pedestal, and through here is the lever that will ignite that other pedestal. The same pedestal, actually. Not the other one, the same one. So it's simple enough. I don't remember the last time I saved, so I feel as though I want to save. I will save right before the timer anyway. Who cares? Let's do it. There we go. So make your way to the other side. And here's the lever. Yes, I said I will save again, so that's exactly what I'm gonna do. So obviously this will be timed. You have just enough time to do this. Pull the lever, roll, run and jump and grab. Hop down. Mine that spike trap. Grab your torch. Don't get too close to the fire. I thought I was gonna miss it. I just made it. Because don't get too close to the fire, because it will set you on fire. Light this brazier. And now get rid of your torch. So once you've done that, the gate to leave will open. So that's up here. Here we are back in this section. So lighting the brazier raised this block. There we go. So pull the lever and that raises the block on the other side. And it is not timed, but there is a big but. If we come round, we can now see there are little embers on the ground, like little tiny fires. And if we step on a tile with one of those little fires, that block will lower. So there isn't really a way to get to that block because of those little embers. So that's what the monkey bars are for. You need to come up here and grab the monkey bars. Random monkey bars aren't so random anymore. So you can't even try and jump over the fires because you've hovered over that tile. So that immediately lowers the block. Okay, so drop when you get to the end. Jump into the gap. Grab this zip line. Don't let go. And now we will slide into the next level. So thanks for watching, everyone. And I'll see you next time. Take it easy.